dying. Okay, you're going to be smiling, folks, after you see this. Oh, it's all good stuff. It's hard to believe, but it is time for the annual Turkey Trot put on by the wine growers of the Grand River Valley. And Cindy Lindberg, who's the owner of the Grand River Cellars, is here. She's talking about the event. Also, she has a wonderful recipe for us.
Yes,
it's such a great idea. And then tell you what you can expect this weekend.
Absolutely.
I can't believe it's already time.
I know. It's October went so quick, and we're just finishing up harvest this week, and I got to tell you, the winemakers are so excited. They're talking, these are some of the best grapes we've ever seen out of the Grand River Valley.
Are you kidding?
Yes. Look for big things to come. Yes.
That's great. Well, this is a great idea as we're starting to prepare for Thanksgiving.
Yes.
So we can show you some wonderful ideas for wines to go
yes.
with your different dishes and stuff like that. So it's a fun, super fun weekend.
It is. The whole purpose of the event is really to help the consumer figure out which wines to put on that Thanksgiving table. And so we brought a variety out to, you know, there's rosés, there's your Riesling, there's the Pinot Noir, which is a lighter red. If you want to skip the dessert, I have to recommend the cask wine and just have a nice glass of red at the end of the evening
yeah.
and save on a few calories there. But it's a fun event for you to go out, experience the end of the harvest season, and really figure out what to get for your Thanksgiving table.
We'll break down all that the wineries have to offer, but this is an event coming up on Saturday that it's $5 at each winery, and you get a pairing of food
right.
and wine. And if you bring a canned good, then it's only $4.
Exactly. And the, you know, the shelters are really counting on us. Mm-hmm. So we really encourage everyone to bring in those canned food items.
That's great. All right, Cindy has a great recipe we're going to show you. This is a wonderful thing to do after Thanksgiving,
right.
maybe like day after.
Yeah, it's a whole nother meal. So you just take your turkey. Obviously, you take it off the bone. And then you just cut it up into very small chunks.
What a great idea to do on that weekend after Thanksgiving
mm-hmm.
when you're looking for some ways to use up your leftovers,
right.
but something super unique.
For sure. And we always use our white cheddar as our base for our mac and cheese at the winery, but you can get creative with that too. We also do a bacon Gouda mac and cheese. So we'd start with the white cheddar, melt down some Gouda cheese and cream, mix that in, gives it a whole nother flavor.
So it's like
as
a casserole. So you already have your mac and cheese in here.
Yep.
Okay. And then you're putting turkey on top.
Put your turkey on top and then just mix it in.
Great idea. So wait, what kind of cheese did you say that you do the Gouda?
This is a white cheddar, but we'll add Gouda to
it. Oh, nice.
Creamed Gouda.
Just really thicken it up, give it a robust flavor.
Oh, yeah.
So great idea. Chop up the turkey, put it in with the mac and cheese.
All right.
And wait, folks, it gets better.
Oh, yeah. So this is our signature stuffing. It's a bacon cheddar stuffing, a cornbread stuffing that also has a little jalapeno in it. So then take your leftover stuffing.
What a great idea.
And just put it right on top.
Cindy, are you guys serving this dish?
This is the dish we'll be serving.
You
for
are serving this,
trot.
And this is what it looks like. So then you bake it for about how long?
Well, for 30 minutes at 350.
Look at
get
this.
Get it baked through.
So then you have a nice casserole to munch on
meal.
All weekend.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Really hearty.
Yes.
To fuel your shopping or whatever you have planned
right.
with your
That's
family
right.
and friends.
That's right.
Right. All right. So tell us what you brought along today, right
all
here.
Right. So if we start over here with the rosé from Debonair, it's a dry rosé. Dry rosés are very popular. They go great with turkey. Always recommend
nice.
A dry rosé. They're serving their mashed potato parfait.
Look at that parfait.
Isn't that fun?
It's right
Very
here
fun.
In front. It looks so good.
And then, of course, I brought our cask wine just because I always love to talk about the dry red from the region. And so we have that paired with our mac and cheese.
Like that.
And Lorello Vineyards has the Pinot Noir, which I highly recommend a nice red with dinner, and that is the one because it's a lighter red.
Oh.
So it's going to pair with more foods. They have their cheddar garlic cheese ball that they're going to be featuring.
And Brad's here from that
Brad,
winery.
Yes,
so
we have
hi,
the
Brad.
Winemaker.
It's good to have him here today.
In studio. So, and then for Ferrante, their ever-famous cranberry blanc.
Oh, it's so good.
And they have a turkey meatball with a blueberry chutney.
Oh, that looks delicious.
Very nice.
Very
and then
nice.
With the St. Joseph, they did a cheesecake. It's an apple cinnamon cheesecake. Caramel cheesecake, and caramel and Riesling is wonderful together.
Oh,
and
my
so
goodness.
That's what they've featured for that.
So you get to sample all of these wines, all of these delicious foods.
Right.
It's just $5 at each winery. But then if you bring a canned good, which you all are donating to the food bank, then it's only $4.
Yes, and
each
it's
visit.
So much fun. We get you down in the vineyard or down in the cellar and you can check things out. It's a great time to come.
And you can
out.
Start with dessert. You don't have to go and order.
Any order you want, any order you want, and just pace yourself noon to five.
Pace yourself. Right.
Yes.
Have fun.
It's important.
Thank you so much.
You're
Best
welcome.
Of luck. And
thank you.
Thank you for providing this service for us and the food
and
banks.
Now
and
we
we're going
to
dish
indulge.
This up for
yes.
everyone.